it's called The Swiss Shepherd. So I was trying to find a solo to play freshman year. My teacher gave me several to play through. I played through them, trying to decide. I got home from lessons and I went to a recital, and a flute player played this song, and I fell in love with it hearing her play it, and I wanted to play it. So I chose this one, and I have played a lot of fun songs throughout my high school years, but this one still has been one of my favorites no matter what I've played. So it's really fun to play it. And I want to thank Dad for accompanying me, because some of these accompaniments are really, really hard, and he's always been up to the task, and he's always worked really hard to play it, and he's always done a phenomenal job, and if he doesn't think he does, he does a really good job at it. I want to thank him for accompanying me, so let's give him a round. So I recently had surgery, and I'm working on recovering from that, and because of that, I can't quite play as long as I'd like to. So I asked my siblings if they would play throughout to give me a little bit of a break and a little bit of a rest. So next we have my sister Michaela. She will be going into sixth grade, and she will play a clarinet solo that she did not get to play at contest. But if she had played at a contest, I know she would have done a good job. So Michaela's drum.
Thank you.
so next I'll be playing Concertino by Chaminade, and I played this one my sophomore year, and I chose this one for two reasons. One, I love the melody so much, it's so beautiful and relaxing, and I really enjoy it. And there is a really challenging cadenza right in the middle, well toward the end, and I wanted to try that. Now, I don't play it quite how I would like to, but it's been really fun to see how it's progressed and as I've played it again and how, like, as I can grow in my musical maturity, how I can, like, add different spins and stuff to it, so the cadenza has been so much fun. So, I hope you enjoy Concertino.
Thank you.
He will be going into his 10th grade year at Mitchell Christian, and he's been playing organ for about a year now. He's played piano since he turned 6, and so hope you enjoy this next song.
Thank you.
solo on the trumpet, and once again, she didn't get to play that contest, so this is her chance.
Thank you. everything she does, from music to school to work, her family, and friends. I give thanks to Allison for being my lucky number 13. She's my 13th student who I was teaching at the time to make Allstate band. Not only that, but she made Allstate band for 4 years and Allstate orchestra twice. I give thanks to Allison for the inspiration that she has been to me at times without even knowing it. 7 months ago today, I had a joint replaced in my finger. I went into this knowing that there were no guarantees, only the hope of less pain, and of course, the hope of more movement. When the day came that I knew I had to see if I could play, I felt led to play Give Thanks. That you just heard. I already had much less pain, but could I play? When I opened the book, I found the paper marked on the page. Thought that was strange, I'd never seen it before. Two statements on that page jumped out at me. The first was from 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 10. Each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. And then, God gave us gifts and talents that we should use to serve the people of our community. We should use these gifts and talents to bring praise to God. Wow. How appropriate that this was left where it was, when it was. I needed to hear that. Everything happens for a reason. I later found out that I'd loaned this book to Allison, and she used it to play for the National Honor Society program. The piece of paper that I found was a portion of what she had to read for the ceremony. She'd completely forgotten she left it in the book. For this, I'm very thankful, and was once again inspired by Allison. This time, I invite Allison back to the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to perform Pachelbel's Canon, Allison Strong.
teaching me all these years, for putting up with me, and maybe the times when I didn't practice as much as I should have, and just for inspiring me to be a better musician and a better person. So, as she mentioned before, she's had several students make all-state band and orchestra. So she has a bracelet with charms for every student. So I added mine, and I wanted to give, take this moment to give it back to her. And this is what I played this year. So I started working on it back in April, May of last year. Put it away a little bit over the summer and brought it back out. And I used it for a lot of things this year. I used it for all state band auditions and a couple competitions. So this is a lot of fun to play. It's got a lot of varying contrasting sounds. And the opening part is really low, and I love playing the low register. So it's a really fun one to do. And I want to thank again everyone who's helped me get this point, my parents, my grandparents, Mrs. Kramer, and many other teachers. And I want to thank you all for coming, and enjoy the song.